hear ye, gather round for another edition of Young Kings Wrestling featuring the JDF Memorial Sovereign Soundboard. Welcome to the Nuckafee Buckingham Palace. As always, I am the Thespian TC Fontaine, aka TCF Baby. Please say the baby. Joined by King Reek, House of Havoc, first of his name. Back.
Yeah.
Sorry, man. What is this? 263? I think.
Yeah, you know, I'll be losing count.
Yeah, I lose count.
The content.
It do. It's just all over the place. Like doing. Then you got real, like, actual day jobs too.
Listen.
Like, we don't make a living off of this.
Fresh off the clock.
It's crazy. So a lot of stuff going on. Got events like, without spoiling where I work at, because I know how y'all work. Like, if y'all want to find out where I work at, you got to do it the hard way. But, like, my job hosts events, like, every week. So, like, I'll be trying to go to some of them events on the weekend when I'm not working.
There you go. Shit, why
and
not?
And then, like, we had a little get-together with my coworkers last weekend. And that shit was fun. That shit was fun as hell, man. Free drinks. I couldn't believe it. I went in there and I was just like, hey, let me get a Crown Apple.
Hey, say
that's
less.
My shit. I've been drinking Crown Apple for like 10 years. So if I give me, I had like three of them bitches, and I brought like mad leftovers home too. Like, they gave us a number that we had to hit. So we hit that number. We just ordering shit. So that's how I go. I've never been in this type of situation before. Like, never worked for jobs that was cool like that. Like this. Shout out to us having new jobs in 2024.
Thanks.
Hey, man. Make sure y'all subscribe to us, please. Like and subscribe to us on YouTube at YK Wrestling. I would like to let everybody know the entire Young Kings Wrestling podcast archive is available on YouTube now. So go, you want to check out some old episodes, they all there. And it was real easy. I found this out. I was like, yo, changing the game. Shout out to YouTube, adding new features and stuff that I didn't know about. I feel like it's been a thing for months and I just now figured it out. But yeah, shout out to YouTube, letting us get the whole archive on. Platforms and merchandise available at ykwrestling.com. Just drop some new merch. We're gonna have a sale coming up in October. Then we have a spooky.
Yeah, y'all know what time it is.
Might have to do that. We got new merch and stuff, man. Shout out to Jaylan on the beat too for the new intro.
Woo!
It's that heat.
Hey, man.
It's Jaylan. It's heat, obviously. But yeah, boy, we had to.
No boy in the lab. He be cooking.
Oh yeah. We had to get all the freak off affiliations off of this show. So yeah, we had to let our outro go, like had to get a new intro. Like
yeah, man. It's hard now. The tiptoeing gonna be crazy because we don't know how deep this shit go. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we playing it by ear every week.
Listen, we wasn't at them parties though.
Oh no, nah. Hell no.
Cause we not on that level yet. But when we get to that level to where we'll be invited to those parties, I'm not going.
Nah.
Y'all ain't about to be posting pictures of me saying TC Fontaine was there. Shit.
You know what I'm saying?
I might know what was going on.
I might do my, like Marlon did. He said, like, I stepped in there for a minute and I left early. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to see what's up in here. Then once I see some shit that look a little suspect, I'm like, all right, I'm going to holler at y'all.
Facts. I'm going to have to be the mug that. Shout out to Tiffany Haddish. I know she don't get invited to them parties because she talked too much.
Oh, no. Ain't no way.
Like, I'm going to have to be on some Tiffany Haddish just to make sure that either they don't invite me or I leave early. And be like, hey, party's over. Let's get the fuck up. Let's get TC up out of here.
She's going to be texting somebody immediately after.
They like, yo, this motherfucker don't live in the bathroom. I'm out of here. Gone.
Facts.
Hey, shout out to Jey Uso, man. Main event Jey Uso winning his first singles title. the Intercontinental Championship. Listen, he should have won his first singles title a year ago, but that's neither here nor there. He should have won his first singles title in April. That's neither here nor there. I know you. You gotta finish the story. That was the story right there.
And come on. You know something? You know something? I've gotten turned around. On
I started that. Something.
Yeah, because like we talked about it, but like I was not an apologist, but I was like, you know what? It just makes sense. Just get it over with. But now the more I think about it, because I watched, some stuff back. And that pop, when Cody announced that he was going to step aside, let somebody else get in there, that pop that Rock got when he showed up, I just sat back and watched, like, man, y'all fucked the money up.
I'm saying, that's what I've been saying.
Y'all fucked the money up crying for this boy.
That's what I've been saying. And I'm criticizing Cody in character for y'all that don't know. I criticize characters unless stated otherwise. Like if I'm saying, yo, specifically, I don't like this nigga as a person, then I'm offering criticism is by the character. Cody is probably the most self-centered wrestling character in history. And I know, what about Ric Flair? What about Chris Jericho? More than them. Because, Ric Flair was a heel. Chris Jericho was a heel.
Okay.
And Chris Jericho in a different tier anyway. He liked that in real life. Like, I don't think Cody is that way in real life.
Nah, ain't no way.
But he's a baby face, though, acting this way. And it's where's the self-awareness at from a character standpoint? It's just not there. Like, Randy Orton out here cutting a promo. He ain't been on SmackDown in 2 months. And here come Cody interrupting the promo. Ain't nobody asked for you. You mad somebody else get. That's the exact thing that happened with Rock. He just mad somebody else was getting the spotlight over.
Well, he was asking him, like, yo, what's going on with you, teaming up with Roman. So he was coming out to clear the air about that. But my thing was, I got more bothered with what he said. Because how you going to come out here and say that this was tasked to me? That was the night that you said you were done. You said, I'm not in it. You on your own. This is your family and your bullshit to deal with. I'm out of this. I beat Solo. I'm done. And then you came out and got in the mix of this again because,
because he wasn't getting no attention.
Roman talking about it's his WWE because, yeah, he's totally wrong when he says that, right? Oh, can't be right about that. Just because you got a strap on your shoulder.
Listen,
you got to come out here
and
flex.
If you the champion, bro, you don't need to be insecure. You got the gold. You did it. It was hard work. It was literally, how many years? 8 years.
Yeah.
He was gone 8 years. Well, 8 years from when he left and he came back and he grinded for 8 years to get to that point and he's still insecure. That's y'all man's though. That ain't mine.
It's crazy.
That's y'all man's. Shout out to Jey Uso to sum this up. He the fifth member of the Anoa'i Fatu family to win the Intercontinental Championship. There's only been five. I saw that shit y'all tried to do the other day. Y'all posted that collage and y'all had old boy on there. I ain't appreciate that.
Oh. We do that.
Y'all know who old boy is. We're gonna talk about old boy later.
How we do that?
Shout out to Braun Strowman and Bronson Reed. Probably, like I said last week, that was one of the best segments since the tractor at SummerSlam. But they started off with the negativity.
They selling this for me for real.
Was the backstage brawl, honestly.
Yeah. But it's y'all know, I say this all the time. On-site energy is going to sell me all the time. But these motherfuckers, this is big back-ass dudes that just got on-site energy coming the first minute of the show. Like they talking. You got Dom walking in with Liv, like, oh, here we go with this shit. I'm getting ready to tune out. Then all of a sudden, you just
Right.
like, yo, wait a minute.
They
Hey,
was going
man.
crazy.
Some
Last Monster
drive-by energy.
Standing on Raw, man.
Yeah.
That's gonna be some heat.
It's gonna slap.
It's some of the best stuff they've been doing in the last in a while, actually. Been a minute since they had some good stuff like this. One last shout out. You like how we kept the shout outs wrestling centered this week?
Thanks.
I'm getting some more discipline. I was just like, yo, let's lock in. Last couple episodes was almost 2 hours each. So nah, I don't like that. I don't like that player. So we gonna keep it brief.
It's okay.
Another shout out. I walked in the break room at work and it had the news on, and it was just like a new residency in Vegas. So I'm like, who is Smashing Pumpkins? That's the band that
Okay.
Billy Corgan from NWA is
Yeah.
the head whatever of. So Billy Corgan, you keep a check. You getting to keep a check nomination.
Yeah, you might have
You
to
done got the
because
Vegas residency check a week after they done took your show off of the CW. But you
right.
did get that TV deal and whatever other deals you got earlier this year, too. I think I already might have had him on the list, actually. No, I didn't. He on there now, though. He on there now. Shout out to Billy Corgan.
Yeah, no doubt.
I always like people keep checks. It's
Listen, man,
somebody that I
gotta
saw this
give.
week got a real big check that I did not appreciate, but we'll talk about that later.
Oh.
For right now, I mean, we know who we talk about. But right now, let's talk about this week in wrestling history, 1999. Mankind presents This Is Your Life, a life celebration of one Dwayne The Rock Johnson, the highest rated segment in Raw history. And that shit went
Yeah,
like
man.
20 minutes over the air.
Yeah, they were bugging.
Yeah, it was
It
trippy.
was really bugging.
2000, Monday Night Raw debuted on TNN. And I actually forgot to finish my notes here, so I have no idea what happened on this show. My bad. Play as fuck on.
What year was that?
2000.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
So it would have been like around the time of like Unforgiven. When Austin had his first match back and all that shit.
Probably.
So probably
Yeah,
like some
that
Unforgiven
sound right.
fallout or something. I don't know. It's Googleable. It's just gonna take a while. And I just want to keep this flowing. On the other channel, on Nitro, you're gonna like this one. In a cage match for the WCW Championship, Booker T lost the belt to Vince Russo.
That shit, man. Oh.
Bro, yeah, I thought listening is going to get eyes on the show, bro. They say, what is he's not a wrestler? That's what I was thinking the entire time, bro. And it was genius. Nobody else would do it, would dare to do something like that.
Yeah, you're right, because nobody else is that insane and self-centered,
Right.
but well, there's one, but he got a little more sense than that.
Yeah.
Oh.
That one person, he did it, and there was a purpose behind it.
Right. And you know, people might have, reacted poorly to it, but it's not nearly the same reaction we're talking about. When you do it, it's like apathy. When he do it, it's like, oh, come on, man. Like, what you do that shit
Right.
for?
Nobody
Same
asked
thing with
you for this.
Lashley.
Yeah. Anyway,
Crazy.
I have another Vince Russo tidbit at
Uh-oh.
some point in this episode. 2003, RVD defeated Christian in a ladder match to win the Intercontinental Championship on Raw. I want to add that to my playlist. I need to run that back. Elsewhere on this show, Jim Ross defeated Jonathan Coachman in a country whipping match to get Jerry the King Lawler his rights to the color commentator chair on Raw.
Oh, that's yeah,
Yeah.
that happened.
2006, TNA held their No Surrender pay-per-view from the Impact Zone. In the main event, Samoa Joe defeated Jeff Jarrett. That's JEFFJARRET in a fans revenge lumberjack match. Mm. In this match, there were 18 fans who had the role of a lumberjack ringside. And they had leather straps.
Fans. Okay.
That's
what he was doing.
That's 2016, ain't for you. On the same show. Yeah. On the same show, there was it probably wasn't real fans. It might have been like,
I'm about to say, it's gotta be like
paid actors or some shit.
Some people that's getting contracts later.
Right. Elsewhere on this show, they had a 16-man triple chance tag team battle royal. And the rules of this match, both teams had to be thrown out over the top rope before they were both officially eliminated. So, like, one team member could go over the top rope, and that's fine. They stay ringside until their partner is eliminated. But when it got down to the final two teams, then all the original teammates who might have been out the match will rejoin the match, and it would be a regular tag team match. Very convoluted. But that was 2016-8 for you. Unrelated to both of those points, earlier in the week, Vince Russo got rehired to creative.
What?
And by unrelated, I mean that facetiously.
I tell you, it was a time they just like burning money.
Yeah.
Like having
that was his Russo, like, second time coming back to TNA.
Having Russo, Bischoff, and Hogan all under one roof was just diabolical.
Yeah, they were. Yeah. At this time, it was Vince, Dutch Mantel, and Jeff Jarrett on creative. Yeah.
Ooh,
so
man.
That's, yeah, those two crazy concepts, that's where that came from. then my last tidbit, man, 2020, COVID, this is the Performance Center era, but it was probably one of my favorite segments from that time. You remember Randy Orton pulled up with the night vision goggles and the COVID mask?
Oh, he was tripping that night, bro.
Took Ric Flair, Shawn Michaels, Christian, and the Big Show in the middle of their poker game, and they did not see it coming.
Yeah, it was.
Laid all them old niggas out.
It was so ill-prepared. Like, bro, you ain't have to
They thought shit was sweet. He did warn them niggas earlier in the night, too.
He did. It was
like, he told y'all, like, I'm about to cook you niggas later. So, like, just be prepared. And like, we're not prepared.
And when Randy says, listen, I'm going to do something, you can bet good money it's going to happen.
Randy Orton had the decency to warn you niggas.
Right.
When has Randy Orton ever warned anybody?
Like, this ain't
y'all
09.
Still didn't take him seriously.
This ain't 09 where it's like, hey, you know, he just snap out of nowhere, don't say a word, and just start kicking people in the head. Like, he was like, nah, listen.
Yeah.
You have an opportunity to leave and get somewhere safe. If you don't take it, ain't nothing I can do for you.
Y'all didn't even ask to be moved to another room or something. Just like, he knew exactly where to go. Pulled up inconspicuously.
Yep.
Had the janitor shit on. Pushing a trash can and a mop with a steel chair on the motherfucker. And whooped everybody ass.
He was tripping.
Hey, yeah. Shout out to that version of Randy. That was a fun time.
Oh, hell yeah.
Y'all forget he won the title back then.
That was the before we go to AEW crew.
Facts.
Every last one of them is crazy.
Everybody but Sean.
Yeah. That was it.
That was wild. Happy birthday this past week to Kairi Sane, Matt Hardy, Angel Garza, CTE specialist Chris Nowinski. Shout out to him. Seen him on the documentary earlier. That was dope. Shout out to the Queen, Stephanie McMahon. Shane Thorne. Y'all remember Shane Thorne from Retribution?
Oh, my God.
What happened to that boy?
He was the dude with the plastic plate over his face that has
Yeah, the face mask with the little shits on him.
Oh, God, man.
Happy Dirty 30 to Fallon Henley. Shout out to her. Kathy Kelly, happy birthday to her. Aja Kong, Sonya Deville, Oscar, Buddy Murphy, Jason Jordan. Shout out to him. Jenny. That's a J-I-N-N-Y. Y'all didn't watch NXT UK, so y'all probably don't know who that is.
Sorry.
That's Gunther's wife.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Shit.
Okay. Last I checked, yeah, that was Gunther wife. Shout out to Big Gunther out here getting. Shout out to Big Gunther. Steve Blackman.
What happened to that boy?
Shout out to Steve Blackman.
That was a bad man for a long time.
Man, listen, that was my dog. He had to. That was his theme song.
Yeah.
Miss Kitty. Happy birthday to Miss Kitty. Roosh, Tajiri, and Candice LeRae. And I found out what happened to Shane. Hold on. Candice LeRae. It's been a minute.
What happened to that boy?
You need to find out what happened to you.
Yeah, I see Johnny on TV plenty, but
she be backstage doing nothing.
It's a damn shame.
Been in catering, eating that pepper chicken. I found out what happened to Shane Thorne, though, and I haven't watched New Japan in a while, but he's been there for the last 2 years.
Mm. Okay.
And made some appearances on AEW earlier this year, and he's also one half of the Millennium Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champions.
Okay, I didn't know that was a thing, but
putting in some work. Yeah. Steve Blackman could not find anything on him. The search continues. We're going to find out what happened, Steve.
Mm-hmm.
I found like an old shoot interview. Like it was like clips of a shoot interview and they were all uploaded to the channel this year. But I don't know if it's like a recent interview because the video quality looked mad old.
Mm-hmm.
So like, I don't know like what year that was. So I'm not going off of that. But that was really the only thing recent that popped up with Steve Blackman's name.
Dig it. That's so cool.
We're going to find out though. We are going to find out.
Mm-hmm.
Where are we at on the royal address?
All right, so let's start off with something fresh. So the Breakfast Club had a few guests this week. One among them was the former AEW champion, number 52.
Cool.
And, yeah, a couple of things to say. First and foremost, apparently, when I think he got signed to a deal or recently got re-signed with AEW, but apparently before that deal got done and he was re-signed, he claims that WWE reached out to his representation and asked about his availability, but he's happy where he's at and he wouldn't have considered going back anyway.
I was when he ran and told Tony that they was trying to tamper, even though they just asked for his availability. They didn't try to do anything else. So that's not really tampering. Yeah, it's like the run with shit.
Mm-hmm. Ain't it the truth? But then he got his Tony hat on and said, we're about to move. Because, you know, the TV deal speculation has been running rampant with AEW. Apparently, they're going to get Fox. That's what he's saying. He said that.
That's what I said. He told that shit to Queens Flip, too.
Yeah. It said SmackDown's leaving Fox, and then we're taking Fox. We got TNT, TBS, and then we're going to have Fox on top of that.
What Fox? Fox Soul? Nigga, no, honestly, go look at Fox's schedule. Where AEW going to fit in on that schedule?
Ain't no way.
So, yeah, you might be going to a Fox property. Like, yeah, that's definitely some Tubi-ass programming y'all put out, so I can see that. I ain't going to Fox. Monday, they got, the Masked Singer and all that shit, so they got a block on Monday. They're not going to air wrestling on Mondays on Fox.
No.
On Tuesdays, no. I don't really know what they got. They might could have. But then, I don't know. Wednesdays, they already got a block of shows dedicated to Wednesdays.
Yep.
Thursday might be open. But I doubt that. I think they got other shit on Thursdays, too. Because, like, I'm aging myself, man. But, like, Martin and shit used to come on Thursdays. So, like, they might have a block for shows that's similar to Martin nowadays. Like, Fridays is football.
Right.
I don't know what they air on Saturdays, but, like, that's not a good day to air anything. That's not like live sports, like sports. Not
On
wrestling sports.
a related note, Bleacher Report said to be shutting down AEW content, so it's not going to be available there anymore.
Oh, so yeah, they definitely moving.
Yeah.
Hey, if they go to Fox, I'll cut my locks off and eat them on the show on camera.
That's crazy.
Big
Oh,
Fox, like
man.
actual Fox, like where SmackDown just left. Because
Yeah.
that's what number 52 was saying. Yeah, SmackDown left and we're getting picked up. So he
Yeah.
said it, not me.
Yeah, we're talking about the main lane. Like, we're not talking about,
Fox Nation.
we're not talking
Probably gonna
about
be on the
the
Fox Nation streaming app that
yeah,
nobody don't download.
like, not the great value
They're
version
gonna put
or
y'all on FS1 and take over Skip Bayless.
hey, that's done already. So,
Just
I mean,
throw y'all
we
on there at 9 a.m. every morning. Like, yeah, here you go.
hey, man, it's gonna
Anyway.
be like that. The other guest so happened to be Miss Mercedes Moné, and she had an interesting discussion about her decision to leave WWE that had a little bit of something that we hadn't heard before. So she said it was a bunch of different reasons. A lot of stuff happened with herself and the chairman, Vince. But she said, I didn't like how he talked to me. Apparently she said she was talked down to. And she felt like, it was a point in time where I had to listen to my heart. And in that moment, it just seemed like it was time. He said, he was after being talked to a certain way. Says, if you let that happen, if you let that slide, then what message are you sending to the fans, young fans of you, and eventually your kids one day? So had to walk away. That news just so happens to coincide this week with a documentary drop that we're gonna talk about, but
Oh yeah.
I found it interesting.
Shout out to them.
Oh man. So I always love when I get to do this. The Seltzerverse decided that they wanted to report Thunder Rosa was cleared to return and she'd be back very soon. Wrong again. Quoting
Yeah,
her
paper rules,
here.
Cap. Totally, Cap. That means lie.
I'm gonna quote Miss Thunder Rosa because she made a post to clear the air. I just want to make something very clear. I just got a note from the dirt. She said I was cleared to wrestle after a concussion. No, I'm not cleared. I was following the concussion protocol this Wednesday, and I'm not cleared to wrestle. So if you're a dirt sheet writer, anyone, ask me about my health directly. Again, one more game. Ask about my health directly, because I'm not cleared. When I am cleared, when my
Message.
doctors tell me I can wrestle, I will announce it. So, can we stop putting things out there that are not right and not true? There's more to it, but that's the main thing about it. I love when I get to do this. Right. Y'all, man, $13 a month. Or is it more?
15.
Is it 15? 15.
15.
15. 15. God damn, man.
14.99 to be exact.
I on the way home, I spent
Not
$15. Then
factoring in taxes.
I spent $15 and I got myself a whole thing of food. I got a nice big ass quesadilla with sides and everything. $15. I spent $15 to eat, and y'all spent $15 to be lied to. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. I'm gonna move on.
Important question. What
What's
protein?
up? Steak and shrimp.
Hey.
Oh
Okay.
yeah.
Surf and turf.
Yeah,
Okay.
they was going in. They was going in.
You went to the little Mexican taqueria?
Now, Bubba Coos.
Okay.
Yeah.
Listen, I ain't gonna lie. I'll go tear up a Mexican food menu. I
Oh,
just
of
don't want to eat no
course.
seafood off of that joint. I'm scared.
That's what I
That's the only thing that scared me.
did when I was in Texas last month. Yeah, I found a Mexican joint on the Riverwalk. Hey, man,
Ooh.
I'm like, you lucky. Yeah, I gotta go to this wedding in a couple hours because I love to put my feet up.
Shout out to Mexican food,
Oh,
man.
amen. Amen, brother. So, airports are never a great place to go when you're in the wrestling business. But of course, somebody just so happened to find three individuals who got off a flight together. That would be Matt and Nicholas Jackson. With them was none other than Shane McMahon. And they made the post on Twitter. Interesting flight today after taking a picture, the three of them together, with some snot-nosed little fan asking for a photo. So, yeah, the speculation has already been about, Shane potentially taking a leap, getting involved. I mean, we've seen pictures of him meeting with Tony and all this other stuff, the rumor mill going crazy. You never know. You never know at this point. After watching the doc, now I'm kind of thinking like, this nigga must got the chip on his shoulder the size of Texas. Like
Yeah.
he might be trying to prove a point.
You know how that go. I
Oh
would
yeah.
hate to see it.
I would too. But I mean them McMahons are wired different as we've come to find out, so
For sure.
yeah. So oh wait, hold on. That's bad. That's not good. That's not valid news. Let's move on. Big E. I saw a name and I said, nope, we ain't going there. Big E gave us an update. Said in a couple months he's going to
Get
get
some scans.
some updated scans on the neck. Gonna find out if he can make it happen soon. He said, I'm just taking every day as it comes right now. Another 3 to 6 months, he said, and I'll do some more scans. And if they're looking good, if they're looking, solid, and the doctor say it's healthy enough for me to come back in, then I'm gonna sit down and have a conversation. But not gonna worry about things I can't control. Just gonna be nice to know if he can get the opportunity to get back in the ring and if he can do it healthy.
Hey, I'm very
But
selfish. Selfishly, I want the first little bit of action he do to be at WrestleMania, which is going to be in Las Vegas.
oh yes, sir.
So I would like to see that first bit of action. Like, I know the Rumble coming up before then, so like if you get cleared before the Rumble, then we might see him in there. But I know
I
he in
need it.
shape.
I
And
need
he
it,
in
man.
shape enough to do some Rumble spots if they clear him. But selfishly, I want him to come back and get his first action in April.
Yes, sir. Yeah, man. I'm on that train because we got to see Big E in person, but it's
Yeah.
different now. It's
I've seen
different
Big
now.
E multiple times.
Yeah. But it's different when you had a moment like this where the availability is in question. We don't know if he's gonna be
Yeah.
able to do this. So,
You don't know when that bump car getting filled up.
yeah, man. It's true. It's true. Gonna be
Might have
worried a
cleared some
little bit.
space in there. Knock on that wood. Where we at
Yeah,
next?
man. So last little tidbit. Sean, your GOAT, Shawn Michaels,
Yeah.
was talking about,
He goat.
the move to the CW this Tuesday, and talked about some things that's gonna change up. Read this little quote. Certainly, we want to make a big splash on the CW network, so we'll have some big changes. But I think more of that will be from a look and physical standpoint. We'll still be what NXT is, which is bringing some of the most talented, young, diverse athletes in all across the country, developing them into the stars of tomorrow. The hunger, the passion that's always been the core value of NXT is always going to be there. But certainly, we'll try to put some pretty cool bells and whistles for the CW launch on the first. And the opening match, of course, is going to be Roxanne Perez versus Julia for the NXT Women's Championship. That's about to cook. I like it.
Yeah, man. I still ain't figured out how to, watch CW. I don't know how to access that.
Me either. I have been trying to find out. But
Yeah,
I
it's just
guess.
like I'm gonna wait last minute and then just like it's gonna be right
Man.
before showtime. I'm like, oh, I can't figure it out
Yeah, I'm gonna
and
have
get
to
mad.
because I done forgot they said they're taking the stuff off of Peacock, so now I gotta figure it out.
Oh yeah. But I heard CW be showing like college football on Friday nights, so like that'll give me a reason to find it too.
Okay, all right. I'm in for that. Shit.
Yeah, we need that.
Yes,
What else we
sir.
got, man?
That's it. That's it.
Think I got something else, man. SummerSlam 2025 in MetLife. The first
Course.
two night SummerSlam. And then the first Raw on Netflix, rumors of it being in the Intuit Dome in Inglewood. That's where the Clippers play at now. Because they got the
Woo.
fuck up out of the Lakers home base finally.
Man.
And they got them a new nice ass arena too. It's nice.
That's
LED
crazy.
screens all over the place.
That is crazy.
It's just what these arenas is just about to be all LED now. Like that's what everybody about to do from this building. And then the Sphere in Vegas, y'all just about to just make full LED arenas, and that's what it's gonna be
Yeah.
from now on.
They having fun with it.
That's doing too much. It's doing way too much.
Hey,
Y'all
the
tripping.
Clippers spend all that damn money on that arena. They better get some good basketball. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all better be able to hang a banner up in that motherfucker.
Right.
Y'all better hang a banner in the next 5 years. I don't want to hear shit ever.
I'm saying, man.
Been terrible my whole life.
Sitting up there like Kawhi won't even show up for postseason play no more. So y'all gonna have to go in a different direction.
Shit, Kawhi don't even show up for regular season play no more. Ain't no
Nasty.
Paul George no more. They did get some motherfuckers in there. I'm actively rooting against them. They got a old boy on here that beat up his baby mama. They got two niggas that beat up their
Oh
baby mama
yeah.
on the team.
Who the other one?
Nah, it was one nigga that beat up his baby mama and another nigga that beat up a WNBA player.
Oh, that's nasty.
Yeah. That's how the Clippers rocking out here.
I see that. That's crazy.
Ain't my team though. It's all good.
Yeah.
Wouldn't let that shit happen to me though. Hey man, what we watched this past week? We could just talk about the one thing that we all watched this past week.
Yeah.
The Mr. McMahon documentary on Netflix. How we feeling about this, man?
To be honest, they didn't go as deep as or as hard as I thought they was going to.
Yeah,
Majority
I
of the
thought it was
stuff
about to be
was, it
a
was like
hit
stuff.
piece, kind of.
Yeah. Like I'm thinking like we're gonna get a whole bunch of new info that we ain't got before.
It
A
wasn't
lot of this
fussed.
stuff, yeah, it damn sure wasn't. A lot of this stuff was, things that had been talked about or, other people told these stories and things like that. But now it's just coming, from
First
the
account.
horse's mouth. Yeah, now it's
Yeah.
coming straight from him. But no, like I heard a bunch of people involved with it and weren't involved with the talk about like acting like it was a hit piece, acting like it was just raking him through the co It was a documentary. It was a full account from beginning to present day of everything that's going on with this man as far as him and the business that he runs. It's not our fault that he chose to make certain decisions, like working for his dad and then taking over his company and then taking all the territories, talent, so that he could be number one. You know what I'm saying? That, the screw job, Owen, all the shit in
The
the Attitude
scandals.
Era, the scandals, like he did those things and he sat right up there and gave his account of doing those things and his perspective on those things. So I don't
Yeah, I
understand
remember
how it's
grinding my
the
feet in Eddie Couch.
thank you. That's like that's dead on. If you know, we're not going to get into it because
Right.
you shouldn't not know. But that's like dead on with it because it's like, how is a hit piece if the man is saying, yeah, this happened that way, and this is why I did it? It ain't like there's a bunch of people just talking about it and he not giving his two cents. He's the centerpiece of this the whole thing. Vince had never talked about his life before. I never thought I'd see the day.
He did like that one interview like 25 years ago.
Yeah, and it was oof.
Which I'm surprised people don't reference that interview a lot more now.
Oh yeah.
Because like anything you wanted to know about him over the last 25 years, it was all there.
Right. That's why it's
There
like
was a lot of speculation, like he's just like this full-on mystery, like this nigga Michael Jackson or something.
what I'm saying, like the level of shock that came from people when it started blowing up, it concerned me because
Like I said, it wasn't
he,
for us.
yeah, you can say all day long, oh yeah, well, he's playing a character on TV, but certain things, it's like when you just go there, it's like, nah, nigga, some of that is real. Like
Facts.
you really feel that way. It's like when you joke around with somebody who's racist. You know what I'm saying? Like they make their jokes. Like no. That's not a common joke. Like you thought of that. You put time and effort into making that joke, motherfucker. You
Right.
say nigga a lot on the weekends. I know you do. But hey, you said it perfectly. It wasn't for us. Because I was anticipating a lot more than what we got, but hey, it is what it is. I ain't tripping.
Yeah, it was still a good watch. Like if you're a wrestling fan, you are aware of most of this. Like, so this was for people who weren't dedicated wrestling fans. But I got a few notes on just some things in here.
Oh yeah, me too.
Your boy Terry. Hold on, let me write that down.
Oh
Boy, it ain't a documentary if Terry Bollea ain't capping on it, is it?
man. But see, I didn't feel like he was going like too much. You
He
know what I'm
yeah,
saying?
he wasn't going hard on the cap, but
Yeah.
he for the most part he was saying stuff, and then like rare Hulk Hogan that he was kind of showing some like accountability for his bullshit in a way. And I was
Yo,
just like, yo, who is this? Yo, Smack, who is this nigga?
that's a
Like,
fact.
but he couldn't help himself because we out here talking about WrestleMania 3. And he was
Oh,
like, yo, I
God.
didn't know that I was gonna lose it. I didn't know if I
Come
was
on
beating Andre
now.
or not until the ref counted three. Shut up.
Really? Really?
Shut up. You knew you was beating Andre.
Like, come on, bro.
Your other boy, Bret Hart. Neither of these are my boys. This is your boy.
Oh,
Bret
no,
Hart.
they ain't.
Bret Hart implied that he was King Arthur.
Bro, I.
He said there was Lex Luger, Ultimate Warrior. I was the one that was able to pull the sword out of the stone. That's my Bret Hart voice.
Yo, I hollered from a healthy place when he said that line. I'm like, sir? You did what?
You tripping, bro. Vince claimed the Attitude Era was family friendly.
The biggest
As the
takeaway,
editing team had receipts for everything he said.
and that's too. Like every time he said something crazy, like the level of delusion that came out of what he said, that's like the most impactful part of it. Like he's candid, he's saying what he truly believes, but damn it, you have got to be lost up here if you really thought, like, oh my God, this was family-friendly television. No one got killed. No one was raped. No one was nothing wrong was happening on TV. Like, hey, what?
Nigga, you got $1 billion from Peacock. I can go watch everything that you just said didn't happen and watch it happen
Boss man was hung on TV.
on WrestleMania.
Yeah, your biggest show. That happened.
Was tripping.
Like,
You had a nigga get crucified and hung. There was a date rape all in the same year. A nigga got ran over that same year, too. That was all in 1999.
that was dropping whatchamacallit, dropping cars off of in forklifts and
Killing
shit.
dogs. Y'all killed a dog
Yes.
in 1999.
Y'all tried to kill Rock.
They tried to kill Rock multiple times, too. The Rock has had so many attempted murder plots against him. Like in 2002 alone.
You had
In
a
February 2002, The Rock got tombstone on top of a car, and then what the NWO did to him in Chicago. Like, that happened to him in the same month.
This man had a cult kidnap his daughter.
Mm-hmm.
And whole time while he's acting like the victim, he is orchestrating the entire storyline.
Because of one employee that he could have just fired like everybody else.
Which, by the way, that employee drank beer every single night and threw
on the clock. Middle fingers
and on the clock and threw middle
assaulted
fingers
you
into the clock. A crowd full of families, including children, middle fingers and beers.
And you let it happen because he was making your ass more money than you ever made.
Exactly.
Who mans? More notes. Tony Atlas said Pat Patterson grabbed his pecker, his pole. And the producer was like, nigga, what?
First of all,
the producer was shocked. He was like, what?
I knew we was in some trouble when I seen Tony Atlas ass sitting there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like, where did y'all get him from? Remember, I've spoken to Tony Atlas in wrestling before. Okay. I know this is a wild dude. Like, I don't know. Over here with the Fred Flintstone shirt on. Like,
yeah, somebody said Tony was dressed like Fred Flintstone. Boy, I was in tears.
Yeah.
I was in big tears, dude.
Oh, my goodness. That is crazy.
But shout out to Tony Atlas.
But it's like, listen, at least there's some confirmation. Because, again, a lot of this stuff was rumored and speculated and all the stuff that got passed down. And leave it to Tony Atlas to be straight up saying, like, yeah, he was walking around the locker room and just grabbed me.
Hey. He walked up to me, grabbed my pecker.
Yup. Okay.
Okay, bro.
So Pat Patterson.
You know, I believe too. Shit.
I do too. Pat Patterson was out here grabbing men by the pussy. Oh boy.
Hey. Your boy is my boy too. What? Oh, man. Stone Cold Steve Austin said he doesn't believe in CTE.
Oh God. Because he's never had
which
it.
Which goes to say,
my CTE acting up.
Because only a nigga with CTE would say some shit like that.
Like, he almost had your neck broken. I don't even think. How do you even fix your mouth to say?
How many times
you
been dropped on your head, Stone Cold Steve Austin? Stone Cold had his most recent match 2 years ago. I literally saw him get dropped on his head on concrete.
Yeah. Like, how do you fix your mouth to say that shit?
Yo, goddamn, I don't believe in no goddamn CTE, no way.
And that was the real sad part because
I've done every single person we've talked about on this documentary, I've done their voice. It's OD.
But it's like when they started talking about that. And this man is really sitting up here saying that CTE wasn't adding up because all these moves that he did, they were worked. No shit, they're supposed to be worked. Do accidents not happen?
Right.
Like, you're falling from that height. And even though you do your best to protect your head, it's not always going to happen. Dynamite Kid did the move before him and told him, don't do that move. It's going to ruin you, your way of life. And he did mm-hmm. it anyway. So you couple that with chair shots, unprotected, and any other plethora of issues. Like, the man was a crazy ass, you know, dynamo going back and forth all over the place. Just accidents and attrition. How can you not sit up there and say, like, yo, the head injuries, you know, they might have something here. But you just vehemently deny that, oh, well, the moves are work. He's not really getting hurt. He's not actually taking head damage. Like, you actually watch your own product, bro? Like, I was using the term delusion a lot. Delusion. My God. My God.
Shane McMahon, here comes the money. Let's talk about Shane real quick.
Oh, yeah.
He just wanted to make his dad proud, honestly. We talked about Vince's childhood on the first episode, I think it was. Talked about how like he was abused, suffered abuse in the household, didn't meet his biological father till what, he was like 12, I think they said.
Yeah.
Around there.
All right. Yeah.
And then him, he, you know, Vince Sr. was just like kind of not as ruthless as, you know, Vincent K would turn out to be. But you see where Vincent K got it from.
Oh yeah.
Like he was cold. Like Vince Sr. was cold to Vince Jr. And Vince Jr. was kind of cold to Shane.
Mm-hmm. Like
Vincent K said that his pops didn't tell him that he loved him until the day before he died. So yeah. Hurt people hurt people. Like,
oh hell
so,
yeah.
And like Shane, I don't think got the sense that his dad was proud of him until he had the match with Taker.
Yeah. Tried to damn near kill himself.
Right. Years of killing himself. Speaking of killing, this dude told Shane to kill him over a creative disagreement.
Bro, when Paul told that story, I'm like, yo.
Hey, Paul Heyman did not have to be so thematic with it, though.
He didn't. But what I wouldn't have expected anything less. Like, it's
right.
He is a storyteller as much as anyone else is there. But man, like he's just telling, and I'm seeing the scene in my head. Like, this is
insane.
This is some Godfather shit he talking about right now.
Take that knife, goddammit. You're not man enough. And he was challenging him. He said, yo, I took down everybody, including my father.
Right.
You don't have the guts to take me down. You want to run shit, nigga, take me down.
Mm-hmm.
Like, let me find out Shane blew the whistle.
Wait. He might have. Like, bruh.
He said, okay, nigga, you said it.
Like, the way they put that whole thing out there, man. I'm like, oh, no wonder he left.
Mm-mm-mm. Yeah, it's tough. Shout out to Shane. Shane showed up at AEW. I ain't going to want to see it.
Nah. But I had something, too. Hey, realistically, I like how they sat up there and basically admitted that they booked the Trump presidency.
Mm-hmm.
They wrote and scripted every piece of that step by step. Like, man, it's good to have some confirmation on that.
I've been saying that. That's why, like, nothing he would go like on the news and say bothered me, but everything bothered everybody else. And I'm like, yo, this dude, just he living out his WWE fantasies. That's all this is. Like, I'm not impressed. Unfortunately, it's affecting real people, but like, I think like we all can collectively ignore it. That's the problem. We don't collectively ignore it.
Yeah.
Like, sometimes you gotta ignore some bullshit and it go away.
Like, you haven't noticed that all these people like on either side of the fence when it comes to Trump or whoever else, they all act like wrestling fans now.
Yes.
Like, the tribalism is insane.
That's y'all. Hey, dead ass, bro. That's really how it is. That's why I don't know if wrestling fans is political people or like political people is wrestling fans. Like, I don't know who trying to be who.
It's crazy.
Y'all wild, man. My last thoughts, way too much Meltzer again. Every single episode he was on it. And then like they didn't get to finish their interviews with Vince after the lawsuit dropped.
Nope.
Or after like the initial report dropped. Canceled all his interviews. So like the last 30 minutes, there's no Vince obviously talking about this period of his life. Yeah. So we have to resort to like a full court press of Dave Meltzer in the last 30 minutes of this shit.
Ooh.
Netflix, I did not pay y'all $15.49, which is only 50 cents more than a Dave Meltzer subscription. I did not pay y'all $15.49. To see Dave Meltzer all over the screen. I just did.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. The first five episodes.
At least his office was clean.
Please. They had
some people, camera tricks.
I'm about to say they had people ready for this.
Hey, no, they did. Hey, listen, the background was kind of shadowed out. They kind of made the shit dark.
Hey, oh.
They did I believe some, it. It's some good lighting tricks, man.
Movie shout magic out, my out
lighting.
here.
Yeah, shout out to my lighting people in film. They know how to make stuff happen.
Yeah, man. But no, like the first five episodes, I understood the involvement because, listen, that majority of his time frame was his the time of his power, so to speak. Like that was the time where if you wanted to know what was going on in the world of wrestling outside the ring, you go to the Seltzerverse. So I understood. I didn't even complain or nothing like that, like I usually would. I had to accept it this time. But in the end, nah, bro. Ain't no way. Ain't no way. But I think realistically, Vince is sitting up here trying to sell us one last time. Mm-hmm. Like, it is crazy because. And that's the one part where he said he wanted to book Steph and Triple H's wedding on pay-per-view because he really thought that was going to make some money. Like, this man will try to sell anything. And I think his goal in being involved in this was, yeah, let me just sell it one more time. But then it just took a left turn because now your shit is starting to come out.
Bruh.
Which I don't even think he is ready to accept the fact that, yeah, you might really be this monster that motherfuckers is telling you about. Like when they brought up that rape back from the 80s,
mm-hmm.
he snitched on himself. Like he really did. He took, I got the quote. He says, once you're accused of rape, you're a rapist. But it was consensual. And actually, had it been a rape, the statute of limitations have run out. That's like OJ writing a book. Oh, right. If I had done it, this is how I would do it. You snitched on yourself. Like, bro.
Hey, he also admitted to wanting to do that incest storyline, too.
Yeah, it's like, bro. We're laughing about it. Like, bro.
One of those things was that I impregnated her.
You know you're not right
this
in the head.
This is a sick Negro.
Like, you know you're not right in the head for that, bro. Come on, man.
To lighten this up before we move on, I think this needed more Durag Vince coverage. I think we needed more on the Durag Vince. They skipped right past that. They just talk about, yeah, around this time, yeah, they had the death of him, and they went straight to talking about Redacted. They didn't cover nothing about, like, who had the idea to put a do-rag on Vince after he had to shave his head? Who taught him how to put the do-rag on?
I'm saying.
That's what I really want to know.
I was there for this. Like, bro.
Yeah.
You just going to speed past it like it didn't happen?
We need to speculate. We need to speculate right now.
All right.
Who taught Vince how to put on a do-rag? Who taught Vince McMahon how to wear a do-rag? I think it's prime time. That's what I'm thinking.
I was literally just saying, like, Shad and JTG was told to roster at that time. Like, yeah.
And if it wasn't him, second had to be Elijah Burke.
Mm, okay.
I'm just thinking people that was around in 07 that could have been like sense. And then MVP was also there, too. So I'm just saying all the niggas that had braids in 2007 on the roster. Mark Henry might have taught him how to do
it. They all huddled up with him like, all right, listen.
It was probably a whole collective.
I'm like, listen, if you're going to go through with this, I ain't really rocking with this decision that you're making, but if you're going to do this, you at least do it right. Don't have us out here looking terrible.
His do-rag is on too good.
Yeah, like, you know, if you're talking about this right here, you got to make sure you're wearing it right. So let's just have a seat and let's educate you real quick.
Facts.
This is how you got to walk when you go out there too. Like somebody had to get that there.
High key, low key. Vince probably been know how to put on a do-rag from back in the Attitude Era.
Mm.
Because low key, like, I brought up Mark Henry, but Mark Henry might have, with the Nation, D-Lo Godfather might have all taught the nigga how to do that back in the 90s.
I'm about to say, yeah, that makes sense.
We should have asked Elijah Burke that when we interview him.
Oh, man.
Who taught Vince how to put the do-rag on?
Hey, we got to get him back in here. I got Facts. More questions. I got more questions.
Hey, man, let's wrap this up real quick, man. Bad Blood, live from Atlanta, Georgia. That's what they should have did that. They should have did a Ludacris. The Ludacris and Jamie Foxx. Remember that?
Oh
Georgia.
Yeah. Yeah,
but now the theme song is GTA by Future and Metro Boomin. So, yeah, seeing Triple H tweet about Future was crazy. That was crazy. Hosted by the tag team champions, Bianca Belair and Jade Cargill, appropriately. Like, you could not have black women hosting in Atlanta. So yeah, about to get it's about to be a party in that month.
And you see they had Cardi in the SummerSlam joint too.
I'm unfortunately, yes. Y'all doing too much now, bro.
Yeah.
Cause like I'm not a fan of pussy rap. That's why I call it pussy rap. I'm not a fan of pussy rap.
Nah, I feel
it's nothing but pussy rap all over my wrestling nowadays. I don't like
it.
It's pussy rap at SummerSlam next. It's pussy rap on Friday night, SmackDown every single week. Y'all about to have more pussy rap just clouding up NXT in a couple weeks, too. I don't like it.
Oh,
musty pussy rap on NXT.
I'm not a fan, because y'all gonna act like I'm number 52 if I say some shit. Because I just,
hey,
that one in particular, I don't know why she's ever on TV. Like,
I don't know why. Listen, I'm gonna go move on because y'all gonna think I'm a Republican up in this bitch.
I'm telling you that's why I'm chilling.
Let's get into these predictions real quick, man. Rhea Ripley challenges Young Wild and Free Liv Morgan for the Women's World Championship. Dom Mysterio is going to be in a shark cage hanging over the ring, and I personally am very eager for this to be over with, bro.
Please, man.
Who you got?
Oh, I'm at a point I don't even care anymore. I hope it's Liv.
Honestly.
I'm like, what? Who booked this? Why?
Say that again, bro. You kind of cut out there.
Yeah, I'm just like, who booked this shit? Yeah. Like, for what? Why do we? I get it.
We was gonna trigger my boy's PTSD. He was locked up in that prison all them years.
I was gonna say the PTSD from 05. This was fighting over his custody. Oh my god. Yeah, but like,
right. I got Liv winning too, because and it's just knock on wood that Raquel comes back, cost Rhea the match. Give them something to do, give Liv a chance to actually like save this reign that she's had. And do something without being attached to Rhea Ripley's hip. It'll give them both an opportunity to do something different without putting the belt back on Rhea so soon.
Yeah.
We can move the fuck on.
Get Raquel back in the mix either which way. And let her beat the shit out of Liv. Something. Yeah. Like, I need this to be over.
Agreed. Same with the next match. Damian Priest versus Finn Balor. Kind of over it. But who you got in this one?
Oof. This better wow me, because y'all only been beefing for what, a month, and y'all acting like this has been a year long feud. So this better wow me.
I mean, in Finn's mind, it has been.
Well, yeah, because you know, the biggest haters always got the longest stories. I don't know. I guess I'm gonna roll with DP on that.
Yeah, I know Finn needs a win here, but I actually don't care. Like, y'all go out there just like get me interested in the match. That's all I care about. Because right now I'm not.
It's not doing it for me.
Yeah. The whole Judgment Day thing, I'm just not. I'm ready for it to end. And that's all I think about when they're on screen. Like, yo, this needs to wrap up.
Yeah.
It's the same shit now every week. Like when it first, when they first kicked Rhea and DP out the group, like when they first did that,
that's it, it was hot.
But like it's been the same shit every week.
Yeah. Y'all don't have that gear. Like you, y'all like to say, oh yeah, there's no leaders, but at the end of the day, a faction is no good without a leader. Like that's mm-hmm. the part y'all missing. Evolution ain't evolution without Triple H.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, same thing with DX, the Horsemen. They ain't the Horsemen mm-hmm. without Rick. You know what I'm saying?
Like Stables is a different story. Like it's easy when you got three dudes.
Yeah.
Like, you got four or more people. Like you need somebody to reel these niggas in.
Right. Like you can't, it does not work at all. So
yeah.
This whole thing y'all trying to sell, it don't work. It don't work.
Yeah, let's just move on. Next up, we have Nia Jax versus Bayley for the WWE Women's Championship. Shout out to Bayley getting the win over Naomi. Naomi in the Uno gear going crazy.
That's
fair. Nia Jax, I saw how you was acting backstage, and I'm here to let you know right now.
I'm here to tell you right now. Like, are we giving those out? Cause like,
yeah, WrestleMania is in Vegas. I'm just saying.
Hey, listen. I didn't know.
Here. I'm gonna be here.
I didn't know it was free smoke like that. Like, talk to
me. Can we include that in a package at WWE World?
Right. Like that can
I
be
get
the,
that with my
that can be the photo op. I'm dead serious. Ooh, I'll take that photo.
I need that. Oh God. I'm about to see if I can will. Do that.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll make sure hey, I write
choke
that shit
me like
down.
You did, Tiff. Oh God! Who you got winning the match?
I'm doing it. Yeah, not gonna win this. I think the only question that I was to say that was the only question at this point because now because of that whole choking situation, like Barbie looking kind of mad. So I don't know. She might. I think she'll probably feign it. You know, she'll tease it a little bit. But I don't think it'll have to go through. Not tonight. Not that night.
That'd be the best time to do it, though.
Probably. It depends on how the match go. Like if it turns out to be like one of them drag out matches where they really going at it. Probably. Oh, but
better question is, does Naomi cost Bayley?
Oh, I know it's coming. I want to say. It'll happen later, but she about to turn like the all the smiling and happy hugging and shit. I'm waiting for her to finally drop the smile and be like, "Nah, bitch, we ain't like that no more. Like, I'm tired of this. Like, I know it's coming."
I hope she just goes straight to the bag. Like, yo, I ain't forget about that bullshit.
Listen, Team Bad Naomi was the best Naomi.
It was.
That's all I'm saying.
We need that back.
Yeah. Expeditious.
Need that back. Hell in a Cell. CM Punk versus Drew McIntyre. Hey, man. I went a motherfucking slow cooker. Had that automatic shutoff. It's ready. They ain't talked about killing each other.
Dog.
CM Punk better watch his back reffing that match, too.
That's what I'm saying, man. You saw AJ showed up?
Where?
AJ was backstage. I don't know what show it was, but...
I saw his little dog in the ring.
On IG. Yeah, Larry was there and AJ was there. Like, what are you thinking? This... All it takes is for this motherfucker to just pull up somewhere, kidnap AJ, kidnap Larry. Like, you are playing fast and loose with this, and I don't understand it.
Hey, you see the picture of them, like somebody, like an arena worker or something, leaked the picture, like all the wrestlers before the show. And so you had like Mark Henry's son was there, like chatting with somebody. He had like the women's wrestlers working on shit.
Yeah.
Oba Femi was there. And CM Punk and Drew was like talking with each other, like in the corner, like going over what they about to do. It was just like, man. Jim Ross was like, I guess Jim Ross thought like somebody in the company leaked it. And it was like, yeah, in my day, somebody would have been fired Boomer sooner.
Oh, man. JR was like the only person that was missing off of that doc, I tell you, man.
Yeah, it needed some JR. Hey, yeah. Ooh, I forgot to mention. My girl, Trish Stratus, was on that. It feels so good. I popped when I seen Trish. I popped when I seen Tony, but like when I seen Trish, boy.
How 20 years go by, you don't look a day older. Like, what the
bruh?
Fuck, man.
With two kids.
God, man. Since you mentioned when she said, I'm not trying to say I was punished, but it's ironic that there was an angle that I was supposed to make out with a chick, and then the next week I lose the title at Mania. I was like, that's some crazy shit.
Wasn't she supposed to lose the title at Mania anyway?
I don't know. Cause I like
so too.
But see, the end happened so abruptly that I'm like, wait, that's kind of crazy. And then when you see what happened in the match that allegedly Vince was pissed about, which I don't really believe that, but.
And he probably popped for that.
That's what I'm saying. Like, yo.
He is sick Negro.
Like, some of this was like, oh, shit.
Yeah, Brody was tripping.
Yeah, man. Wild.
Yeah. Who you got winning Punk and Drew?
Hey, man, I need a symphony of blood and destruction. This is on my short list for match of the year.
It ain't even happened yet. Me too.
Yeah. But Punk got to come away with the win in this. You know, it's one and one. Realistically, you know, as much as Drew need, I mean, Drew's gonna come out of this looking better no matter what. This is going down to his best work, no questions asked. But there's more to gain out of Punk winning because it's kind of like, you know, these are the latter years. He's gotta get one last hurrah, you know. Yeah. So him getting to conquer this mountain that is Drew at his heel best, you know, that's not gonna take too much off of Drew. Like, you know. He's left over Lasagna for a reason. We can heat him back up anytime we want to. Punk taking the L is just like kind of dropping him down a little bit. You want him back up because once this is over, it's September. So we got a couple months to go before his next project is coming, who's been off TV for a little bit because he got beat up, but...
Mm-hmm.
That's the main course that we got. So he got to win this so that looks better when it comes up. And I'm hoping we do that at Vegas, you know, because
yes, sir.
That's where it need to happen.
I ain't seen it. It'd be 13 years since I've seen CM Punk wrestle.
Facts, man.
Damn. I'm going to need that. And then in the main event, got a question for you, Reek. How many royal families are there in wrestling?
Well, a wise man once said that wrestling has more than one royal family.
They do. And we got two of them in this match alone. Cody Rhodes and Roman Reigns versus Solo Sikoa and Jacob Fatu. Who you got? It's about to go crazy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's wild. Yeah, Cody Roman, the matchup
easily
we never expected to get. Yeah, they about to that. I need that finisher to go crazy. Whatever the finisher combination is, I need it to like, I need it to cook for real, for real.
I need that spear Cody Cutter combo at the same time.
Hell yeah!
Like Cody about to hit the Cody cutter on Solo. And then Jacob Fatu about to go and try to interrupt it. Oh, no, 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 no. Cody going to hit the Cody cutter on Jacob. Mm-hmm. And Solo about to come in, try to hit the spike, and then Roman just spear him. And then the Cody, that's, hey, listen, it writes itself.
Yeah. Yeah, now Cody going to be in trouble, and Roman going to save this motherfucker for the win. And then he going to be like, hey.
And he going to be like, you owe me one.
Hey, exactly. Exactly. Like, yo, you see that shit, right? It's time. And
we go to Saturday night's main event.
What I'm saying. That's how run we me my shot. Run me my title shot. Let's go.
Facts. I'm going to need Future to walk Roman to the ring.
Oh, hell yeah. Roman getting a special in. Cody getting a special entrance. Let Roman get one, too. That's all.
Yeah, I'm Cody saying. Got the HBCU band. It's a Roman can get Future in Metro Boomin. They can do like that. As well, you know?
Play superhero for Roman to come out. Ooh. Yo.
That writes itself.
Hell yeah. Hey.
Let's start naming future songs that Roman can walk
this
out
will to. This will be.
Trap niggas. No, that's for the bloodline. We can give it. Hey, get a bloodline trap niggas.
Mask off with slap.
Mask off? Okay. I'll fuck with that. Molly Percocets.
Tony Montana.
Tony Montana. That's too old. I don't know about
that. He a Niners fan, too.
Hey.
That was their theme song for a minute.
It was. He performed at the NFC title game back in the day.
Yeah. Oh, it was going crazy.
Somebody
that day.
Recorded that video on a potato.
That's a fact.
I'm pretty sure we're going to get this one. It's not official yet, but Gunther versus Sami Zayn for the World Heavyweight title. And we know who won it.
Exactly.
But yeah.
I need Sammy to leave on a stretcher.
Bro, let's like take this nigga off my TV for a little bit. Please, I beg of you.
I don't understand this, man. Like he begging.
Go on vacation. God damn. Like, I don't want to see. Listen, because I listen, bro. If y'all have this nigga involved in war games with Roman in the bloodline, I'm going to be so irritated.
Oh, hell no.
Hell no. Because I feel like wrestling fans, y'all trying to talk this into existence too much, and I'm not with it.
Yeah. Yeah,
let's stop.
The people that go crazy keep cheering for this dude. Like, y'all are really disingenuous. I cannot see what is so... This gets you so roused up about this dude. What is it? I don't get it. Like, y'all acting like he's this hometown hero. We ain't talking about Daniel Bryan. You know what I'm saying? Daniel Bryan got over with me because he entertained me. He was already a damn great wrestler. He was already top of the top. As far as in-ring performances were concerned, it was character. He
wasn't got a loser either.
Exactly. He got a character over and he entertained me. I laughed and I enjoyed more work. Sammy does not do that. I'm just keeping it a buck. Like the honorary Oos stuff aside, you know what I'm saying? The Oosie thing and he got everyone to pop. That's cool, but once he got
the story, Sami Zayn needed Roman Reigns to get pops with me.
There you go. Like that chemistry was what worked, honestly. That's the most invested I've ever been in Sami Zayn, and it hasn't been the same since they kicked him out. Well, he kicked himself out because you know he showed his true colors, but I haven't been invested since. So I don't see why y'all are so invested.
Sami Zayn's best year was 2022.
Yeah. 100%.
From like the whole year. From the shit with Johnny Knoxville, that was entertaining. I enjoyed that.
Yeah.
But that, everything after that, I ain't
listening. The match he had with Johnny at WrestleMania was better than it had any right to be.
Bro.
And that's one of my favorite
matches of all time.
That is a testament to Sammy. So as much as I'm getting on him, I give him full credit because that doesn't happen that well without him.
Yeah, but for the character Sami Zayn?
Yeah.
Get this nigga off my TV. Let Gunther beat the shit out of him. And then take him out for the next 2-3 months. He can come back at the Rumble, get a big pop.
Yep.
He would be like, ah, Sami Zayn's back. And cool. But I ain't with it. Yeah. Shout out to Gunther, too. Undertaker said Gunther should add more, like, chicken shit heel stuff to his repertoire. And he's been doing that.
Oh, yeah.
Because he said, yo, hey, you risk the crowd, like, getting behind you too much.
That's true. That's
all the true. Stuff you do, they like it. So, like, do some other stuff to... Yeah. Shout out to people that actually can take advice out here.
I'm about to say, is somebody actually listening, you know, when a Hall of Famer is giving you advice to aid your career, and we're not being triggered and acting like, you know,
somebody trying to take over people. The company, yeah. To the point where you want to fight them backstage.
Uh-huh.
And nothing was the same ever since.
Terrible. Constructive criticism.
Tragic.
It's okay.
Shout out to Everybody Hates Chris. Tragic. You see making a cartoon version of Everybody Hates Chris? I don't know what you're saying, bro. I think you muted yourself.
I don't know how that shit just happened. I peeped that the other day in the gym, like, what? Thinking, like, yo, what are we doing? Everybody still hates Chris? Like, in cartoon version,
I'll check it out and see how it is. Because, like, you know, I had to get the Netflix for the event stuff. So, like, trying to catch up on some stuff that came out when I didn't have Netflix. And so I started watching the Untold Sports Stories. I seen they drop one on Steve McNair. I watched that. That was pretty good. I realized I watched a lot of them already when I had Netflix. But I seen they have an animated Good Times that's rated TVMA.
Yeah, I saw the preview of that last night.
Produced by
finished.
Steph Curry.
I don't know, man.
I said, what the fuck is this?
I heard JB Smooth voice in there, so. You know,
it's a very distinct voice, too.
Exactly. I'll give JB Smooth benefit of any day because of GTA. Listen. He did his shit with that. That was hilarious.
Shout out to JB Smooth. He be in all the commercials and shit.
Right.
He was legit the face of Las Vegas for a minute.
Oh, yeah. There's
nowhere I could go on the strip without seeing his face. And now I see Jamie Foxx all over the place.
Yeah, that damn Bet MGM shit.
Yeah. I know nothing about that. I'm on record. I ain't trying to get caught up. Hey man, let's plug our socials and get up out of here.
Y'all can find me at ReHavoc24 on Instagram and on Twitter. You can find the Havoc Hour on streaming all streaming platforms where you find Young Kings Wrestling, Anchor, and Spotify, Google Podcasts, and the video version up on YouTube. A new episode, y'all heard it right, a brand new episode is up and available on all of these platforms right now. Y'all can go check it out.
Yeah, go check that out, man. It was a fun time. I enjoyed it. You can follow me if you want to, TC Fontaine on Twitter. What's my Instagram? TC.Fontaine on Instagram. Check out my photography, FOYFlix.com. And check out Young Kings Wrestling everywhere at YK Wrestling. YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, all the stuff.
What's up?
Yeah. Go check out them archives, too.
Yeah, this is weird the whole not catalog. Having
that. Yeah, it's all up there now. This is weird not having the outro. So, like, how do we close this up?
Damn. We got to figure something out. Man.
We'll figure it out. Next week, we'll do something new.
Yeah, no doubt.
In other words, we just going. Who's that one comedian who just like, I'm just walk off the stage when I'm done?
Oh,
I'm drawing a blank now.
Ain't that Ali? Ain't that what he do?
Ali Sadiq?
Yeah.
Probably.
Because I'm watching him a lot lately. He doesn't really have it. He is. He a storyteller. Like, a lot of comics, like, they just, you know, it's all about the laughs and shit like that, you know, the punchline stuff. Like, now my dude is telling stories, you know, in a way that's just on point and getting you to laugh.
Hey, Mexicans got on boots.
Yeah.
See, makes it go. See,
that was good shit.
I would name this episode, but nobody gonna get the context.
Mexican, yo. Oh man, that's a good ass title.
Too. I won't do that. It is. Listen, y'all hip yourselves up to some comedy.
Yes.
In other words, we out of here. Go.